Well, we're excited to be here. I was expecting to drive into town tonight, or today when we got here, and I thought maybe you guys had a town of like, you know, 300 people or something. And I came here and you had stores and gas stations. Wow! Westwood! I tell you, for the last month I keep telling everybody, we're going to Wood, and I could never get the name out because I kept putting in the wrong place, you know, like Woodland, things like that. Westwood. I've heard about you guys for years. I didn't know there was an old hippie community out here. Is there any old hippies out here?
Yeah.
Anna, we should have came and lived here. Hey, you know, this last week, it was interesting. As we were preparing to come here, I had a dream. You know, I'm not one of these guys that gets all these dreams, you know, of you know, the spiritual stuff, woo. But, you know, I did. I had a dream about your town. I couldn't believe it. I woke up in the middle of the night. Well, I didn't really wake up. I woke up in the dream. See, I was in the dream, right? And I woke up, and I was, like, ushered into heaven. And there I was at the gates, and this guy met me, and I don't know if he was Peter or what, you know, but this guy met me, and he was kind of giving me a tour of the area. And he took me to this one kind of, like, they have buildings, but not really buildings kind of thing. It's really weird. I can't explain it, but it's just... Just trust me. So I'm in this room, and there's clocks in the room. There's hundreds of thousands, maybe millions of clocks in this room, and I'm just in awe of all these clocks. And I look at this guy, and I say, what does this mean? And he says to me, he says, the clocks, every clock represents a saint down here on earth, and every time they sin, the second hand ticks. And I thought, wow, that's real interesting. And I looked over on the wall, and Elizabeth's name was on one, and the first time I ever met her was today. I couldn't believe it. But I looked at her clock and Elizabeth, and it went like this. Tick! Oh my, I wonder what she did. Then I looked over on this side, and Ruth's name was under a clock. And it went tick, tick, tick. You know, I really don't know Ruth that well. But I was starting to, you know, wonder. Then I turned around again, and as I looked at one side, there was Pastor John's name under a blank spot. No clock. And I thought, wow. He must not sin. I said, well, what happened to his clock? This guy looks at me and says, we use it in the other room for a fan. You guys know that's a joke, right? I mean, I don't want to start the evening off the wrong way and have you guys think, well, this guy's a liar. He makes up stories.
No, just weird.
Joke. Hey, we have some special people that are traveling with us this summer. They're from the Sunrise Dance Company, and we've given them another name tonight. They're called the Truckee Graphite Dancers. Come on out and join us, ladies. And guess what they're going to do for you? They're going to dance. Here they go. Don't want to forget to turn my app on.
One, two, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, rock. 5, 6, 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock, rock.
9, 10, 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock, rock. We're gonna rock around the throne tonight.
Thank you.
Let's lift Jesus up, girls.
Let's lift Jesus up. Let's lift Jesus up.
God so loved the world that he gave his only son.
Lift him up.
He's the way, the truth, and life for you. He made the price.
Lift him up.
And praise him.
Let's lift Jesus up.
And praise him.
Let's lift Jesus up.
Praise him.
Let's lift Jesus up.
And praise him.
Let's lift Jesus up. Oh, let's lift Jesus up.
Speak it for a moment or two while they catch their breath, because we're having to do another one here. All right. Hey, my Bible says that if when Jesus came into town just before he was crucified, that if the people didn't praise him and cry out Hosanna, that the rocks would have done it. And I think when I read that, I go, well, that's interesting. That means the rocks are alive. Wow, the trees clap their hands. And the birds in the sky, as they sing their pretty songs, they praise the Lord, kind of like this.
Trees of the fields clapping their hands and just waiting for him. Praise
Jesus. Praise.
Take a break, girls. I tell you what, man, I get tired watching them. I've got to do one dance now, you know? You know, I do have a lot of respect for people that do rock concerts every night, you know, and they go out and they just jump around that stage, because I do one jump around song and then I can't breathe for three or four. So. Those guys work hard. I mean, too bad their lives don't count for much. Most of them are in the world, but they sure work hard. You know, years ago we went to Stockton to do a concert one time, and I like to tell a story to let you guys know how flawed we are. Because we go to Stockton, and when we get there, we're going to go to a Victory Outreach. You guys familiar with Victory Outreach? Pretty bunch of girls love Jesus. They give a lot of time to do this for the Lord. One of the things, I gave my life to the Lord when I was pretty young. 12 or 13, is that pretty young, 12 or 13? If you're 8 or 9, it's not, huh? But I gave my life to the Lord, you know, I invited the Lord in my heart. I heard the gospel message at a Baptist church. And man, I went forward. I go, that's the truth. I had no parents, nobody in my family, cousins, aunts, uncles, nobody in my family knew the Lord, no friends or anything. I just went to this church because I had seen these other things that had longer hair than me, and you know, I kind of noticed them. They were girls. So I went to this church because I liked one. And while I've been, you know, God uses that stuff, doesn't he? And I heard the gospel, man. I gave my life to the Lord. There I was, saved. And I went home, but that was it. I didn't know what to do. So I never read the Bible. I never spent any time in prayer. I quit going to the church, you know, once I didn't like her anymore. And so when the time came up in my life, when I hit that critical age, you know, 14, 15, 13, well, 13, 12 and 13, I guess now, but back then it was 15, 16, I started to drink. I started to do things that were not, God didn't want me to do. And I attributed to one thing. I had no power in my life. I didn't walk with the Lord. I never read the Word. And if you leave with nothing tonight except for this, I share this with you. Read your Bible. Don't just listen to what your pastor has to say and take every word for it. You go check it out for yourself so that you know it's God's Word, because God's Word is truth. And not only that, you need to read God's Word more than you need to eat food. Jesus said himself, man shall not live by bread alone, but every word that proceeds out of the mouth of God. So you read it. My life has changed completely since I started reading the Bible on my own and started getting to know my God. What did that cause me to do? I started to get to know him. I started to worship him. Then what I want to do things And then what happened? I didn't want to do the bad things. All of a sudden I saw sin for what it was, ugly. So Lord, help me not do that anymore. So I encourage you to read the Word every day if you can. Make time for God's Word. Made me tired again. There was a guy in the 50s named Elvis Presley. Anybody ever heard of him? We always kind of want to do one of his songs, and this is the one we chose. And it's talking about going to party up in heaven. Hope he's there.
Starlight pop is dancing to the heavenly rock. ASAP is wailing on the sun.
Why was Anna laughing? And you guys join him, okay? You don't have to help him.
Here we go.
And if you do really good, I might sing one of my opera things.
Better get my guitar off, though.
I don't know if she liked it or she was laughing at me.
Here we go.
Tonight, but that was fun. I'm out here. Why don't we do something else like that again? I know what we're gonna do. We have. Let's see. I need three fun young men that just like to have fun. Is there anybody out there like that? Three of you. You're pretty young. Yeah, you're young. Come up here. Yes. Yeah, you. Yeah. Are those guys. Hey, are those guys behind the thing there. Those young guys behind the thing there, I talked to them earlier. Where are they at? Are you guys got guts to come up here? Where are they at?
Come on, Tracy, let's go.
Speedway, come on. This is easy. Oh, yeah. Oh, I'm going to want me. You don't have to sing. I'm not going to make you sing. Are you okay? I'll tell you what. If you come up here and you win this contest, you get to pick a CD or a tape of whatever you want. You want to come? Do I need to have a couple girls come up here? Come on, girls. You come on up then. You said you'd do it. Come on up. You know what we're going to do. Come on.
Come on, Sarah. Let's go.
Come on. Okay, so we got two. We need one more. before the sun goes down. You want to come up? Come on up. We got a volunteer. Okay, the three of you, guess what you're going to do? If you don't really get into this, you look really funny, so you have to get really into this. You guys are going to play the drums. One, two, three, across here. It's going to be air drum contest to wipe out. Okay? So here's how we're going to do it. I'm going to play a little bit of guitar first, and then when I go contestant number one, you play the drums, okay? Bow, 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 you go crazy, right? And then you're contestant number two, and you're contestant number three. But you got to get into it. You got to jump around. I mean, you know, if you don't, it's a dud, okay? And while you, when you're not playing, just keep the beat, okay? Okay, so here you go. This is your big chance. And then you guys are going to vote for the winner. And then they get to go pick out a CD or a tape, whatever they would like. So that does that sound cool? Then you get into it. Okay.
Here we go.
Okay, now just hold that beat right now. Ready? Great, but we can only have one winner. Okay, so is it contestant? You guys clap for the winner. Is it contestant number one? Woo! Is it contestant number two? Is it contestant number three? Contestant number one is the winner. Are we having fun? Do you guys want me to pick on somebody else? Do you want me to pick on somebody else? No? Oh, because you're afraid I'm going to pick on you, right? What if I tell you I'm picking on you? Right there. Yes, you. With this, yeah, you. Nope, nope. A blonde. Yes, you. No! Both of you, yes! Get a mic. I'll tell you what now. Listen, tie Pastor John down because we're, guess what, we're going to sing a song in tongues. We're going to sing a song in tongues. Don't leave. Oh, I'm chasing them away. There they go. Because you may have the interpretation. Ha ha ha! I caught you. Oh, so is that okay, John? Are you gonna handle that? Okay, well that's great. Because you know we were at a Baptist church one time, which we play a lot of Baptist churches, and we love them. They love us. You're Baptist? But listen, I'll never forget this guy's face because it was a little older Baptist church. You know, they were all in their 70s or 80s or something. We played with the speakers behind us, and we turned them down to a volume that we couldn't even hear them. And I said this, and the pastor turned gray. He went, oh, tongues. So I had to hurry and play the song before he pulled the plug. But anyhow, here we go. Let's see if you got the interpretation of this song. That is.
Here we come, just walking down the street, singing to our
travel with us. Ladies, cupcakes. We're going to be in Susanville at the last Friday in August.
We'll be there. Okay.
Susanville at the ballpark out there. We pretend like we're the Beatles. Not as many people show up they do for the Beatles, but good number two. Oh, I am having fun.
One more,
Dancy. Hey, Red. Hey, Red. Your turn. With Elizabeth! Anna will give you the words. You're gonna sing. You're stars. That's what you get for laughing at me. I saw you laughing at me out there. I have the mic. I am not in control. Hopefully the Lord is, right, John? Praise God. Woo! Hey, how many believe that Jesus is coming back? I do too. Matter of fact, I've been waiting for Jesus to come back. I was in jail in 1972, I think.
He spoke to your heart, but you wouldn't listen. And he said he loved you, but you walked away and you said things that weren't very nice. The Lord is coming back and you're gonna be in trouble. If I were you, I would repent on the double.
Hey, la, the Lord is coming back.
The Lord is coming back, and he knows what you've been doing. nation.
Do they still have Twinkies?
No.
You eat them and they last forever, right?
Twinkies.
Woo, we're going to just sing a little love song to Jesus. Have the girls come up and join us. We're going to make them background singers. And since they do, they're here, they might as well. Don't know if they can sing, but we'll have them sing this. Old Sherelle song. The Beatles did it first time I heard it. Only they said baby, we say Jesus. Put Jesus in everything. You know what it would have been like maybe if the world was never falling, you know, and if things went on the way they were in the 50s, maybe it would have been this way. You know, all the songs would have been like glorifying the Lord. Because there's so many love songs back then. You know, you change a word here or there, man, you just point right to Him. And hopefully we haven't stumbled anybody here by bringing them bad memories back, but you would see these songs in a new light. We have kids in our church that don't, when they hear the old songs, you know, they hear them on some radio station, they go to their parents, they say, Mommy, they're singing the wrong words. Because they know them our way. Because they were raised with us. This is called Jesus, It's You. Sha-la-la-la-la-la.
It's just the way you spoke, you touched my heart. It's just the way you died, it tears me apart. Oh, many, many, many days going by, I think about how you died for me on Calvary. Jesus, it's you. Jesus, it's you. Oh, many, many, many. Jesus, it's you.
Sha la 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 la.
Jesus, it's you.
Sha la la.
Give the Truckee Graphite Dancers a hand. My Bible says that God knew me before the foundation of the earth. So He knew me before I was born. And He was with me when I was in my mother's womb. He was with me the day that I was born. He was with me when I went to school, kindergarten, my first time, and got dropped off and went, and I can kind of even remember crying as I was left there. But He was with me. He was with me through my elementary school years. He was with me in the seventh grade. He was with me that day in that Baptist church when I was in the seventh grade, and I went forward to invite Him in my heart. He was with me. Matter of fact, He was with me when I took my first drink of beer, and I got drunk, and He was there. He was with me when I smoked my first joint, did my drugs. He was there. He was there the times that I OD'd. One time, I woke up in a bathtub full of ice because my friends were too afraid to take me to the hospital because they thought they'd get in trouble. So they went to the liquor store and bought the ice and took my clothes off and threw me in this bathtub. And then when I woke up some hours later, what's going on, man? Why you OD'd, man? Jesus was there. He was there that day when I went into courtroom and that judge said, 1 year continuance. And I was in this nice courtroom, you know, with this carpet and these nice pews. And then boom, that door shuts, man, it's cement and bars. Jesus was with me. Then He was with me the day I got out, you know, and while I was there, the security guard came and he shared the Lord with me again, and I rededicated my life to the Lord, man, and I was a maniac for Jesus in jail, I'll tell you. He did not want to be in jail with me if he didn't know the Lord. Problem is, I never read the Word. I didn't spend any time in prayer. I just told people about Jesus. I just knew who He was. I didn't know anything about Him. I just was saved. So the day that I got out of jail, my girlfriend before I went to jail, who is my wife now, I met her when she was 16 years old, and I went off to jail, and I came back, you know, I went to see her again. So I went to go tell her about Jesus. And all my friends, I said, tell them all about Jesus. I'm going to get them saved. So here comes Jim, man. He's coming out of jail. Yeah, I go over to my friend's house, man. He rolls up some dubs, man. Lays out some lines, pops some suds. Next thing you know, I'm toasted, man. And I go to tell him about Jesus then. No, man, don't tell us now, man. We don't want to hear that stuff now. I was right back in the world. Just like that. No power in my life. No victory over sin in my life. The thing that kept me straight in jail was I couldn't get a lot of stuff, I guess. So there I was. Back in the world. As a matter of fact, I move away and I call up Anna one day and say, come and live with me. And we move in together. And I take her to Calvary Chapel of Costa Mesa. Back in those days, it was a tent. Because I was a Christian and I knew that was the way, but I didn't know how to walk the way. And I took her there and she got saved. And there we were living together, the blind leading the blind. And I was 21 years old then. She was 19. 6 years later, got so sick of the stuff. I got so sick of smoking pot. I got sick of drinking. I decided, you know, Jesus, I really want to know who You are. And I went to the church that I go to now. And I walked in, man, and this pastor talked about how much Jesus loved me. Then He died on the cross for my sin. And not only that, He accepts me just the way I am. A mess. I don't even have to change anything. I just have to receive His love. So I go to this church, and guess what? I walk out of this church going, man, Jesus loves me. I'm going to go back there next week. So I went the next week. Guess what? I walked out of that place going, Jesus loves me. I'm going to go back there. I'll tell you what, when you know Jesus loves you, you keep coming around. It's His grace. It's His mercy. So then I started reading my Bible. And I didn't tell the people in that church and the pastor that we weren't married, because the last church we went to, they kept trying to split us up and stuff. When they were right in wanting to do that, they just did it the wrong way. They did it with full condemnation and no love. So we ran from them and moved to Lake Tahoe. Didn't tell them where we went. So we go to this church, we're not going to tell them that stuff. So I'm reading the Word, and guess what I'm reading? I'm reading Corinthians one day, and it says, it is better to marry than to burn. Oh, whoa. Anna, we got to get married. The Holy Spirit, the Father God, Jesus Himself got us married, not any man. And it was from reading the Word of God on my own in conviction of the Holy Spirit. And you know what happened? We got married, and the second we were married, guess what God did? He delivered me from drugs and alcohol and smoking and everything the minute I said I do. I didn't understand that if I would listen to Him and obey Him, He'd take care of all that other stuff. See, the whole time I was trying to quit smoking pot on my own and quit drinking because I knew I wasn't supposed to be doing that stuff. I knew it wasn't good for me, but I didn't know how to quit. And God was saying, marry Anna. And I was saying, I will when I get my life straight. And I couldn't get my life straight, so I married Anna, and then God straightened out my life. Isn't that great? That's God. He can do that in your life. He was with me. Then some years later, when I'm 35 years old, I was 27 then, when I'm 35 years old, one day I wake up and I am very weak. And within 3 days, I'm completely paralyzed except for my mouth. I could breathe and move my mouth, and that's it. But Jesus was with me. And He did some incredible things in my life. And I might share those in a little bit, but you know what? Jesus is here tonight with me and with you. And we'd like to sing this song to Him called Stand By Me.
Should tumble and fall.
You see, because a little less than 2,000 years ago, God became a man and walked to a cross. If you were there at that time, if you were in Jerusalem on a certain day and you saw the children playing in the streets, very early in the morning, blue skies, beautiful nice day, that all the salesmen, all the people selling their wares all over the place, noise, commotion going on, Passover time. You'd look down one street and you had seen two rows of soldiers coming with a Roman centurion in front with three men in the middle. And when you looked at the three men, you would have really noticed one in particular, because he was beat so bad that he almost didn't look human. You see, they had taken him in a back room and they had whipped him with 39 lashes. They beat him so bad. They had put a blindfold over his face and they said, "If you are the Son of God, you tell us who's hitting you." And they took a crown of thorns. In Jerusalem, thorns are like 2 inches. They're not our little rosebush thorns. They're about 2 inches. They're real thin. And they didn't, put this on his head real lightly. They hammered it into his head. So he was bleeding badly. There was no skin left on his back, probably on the front of him. You could probably see, maybe even see some of his internal organs, his bones, his muscle. That wasn't bad enough. They ripped his beard out. "Man, I can't handle it if you pluck one little hair off me." They ripped his beard out. Raw skin, raw meat. Oh, and then they spit on him. And they spit on him. And now we're not talking about a few people. We're talking 300 to 600 Roman soldiers spitting on him, making fun of him, beating him, doing these things to him. He was so weak, he couldn't hardly carry the piece of wood that he had to carry. It was Jesus. And then they took him through town, naked. Took him on top of a hill. And then they put a big stake in one hand and a big stake in the other hand and one stake in his feet. And they hung him there. And you say, why? Because he loves you. He loves me. That's why. He didn't have to do that, but he loved us so much. He knew there was only one way for man to go to heaven, and that's if he paid the penalty for our sin. And that's why he did it. So that you and I could go to heaven. So that we could be restored to the Father. So we could spend forever with him. Never, ever having another tear to shed once we're there. No more pain, no more crying. The most beautiful place you can't even imagine for us. If you were there that morning, and then you were there when they crucified him, and you look at him closely, you may have been able to see the tracks of his tears that he shed for you.
Inside, you know it's true. So take a
Good look at his face. Think about the things that I just shared with you and through the evening about what Jesus has done. And some of you may have never experienced as much fun as a Christian before. Some of you may not be Christians and go, wow, Christians can have fun. I'll tell you what, I have more fun now than I ever had. I don't need any drugs. I only need Jesus. And Jesus says that if you put your trust and your faith in Him and the accomplished work on the cross, if you believe that Jesus died on the cross for your sin, He was risen from the dead, and just acknowledge that, hey, you know, you've done something wrong in your life. You are a sinner. The Bible says all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. Everybody. All those people that you see in church, they all fell short. But they believe Jesus died on the cross for their sin. And God, Jesus, right now is preparing a place for those who believe in Him in eternity right now. And I'll tell you what, you want to go to heaven. You may not think you want to go to heaven, but I'm telling you, you want to go to heaven. I want to go to heaven so bad I can't hardly stand it. I'm so sick of the things of this world, I want to go to heaven. I want to get a new body, you know, that doesn't lose any more hair. That's perfect. And God's going to give me a perfect body. And I'm still going to be who I am. Except for I'm not going to sin anymore because He's going to change my heart. I'm going to have a heart transplant. And spiritually He's already done that. And He can do that to you tonight. He can give you that tonight. He can give you a free ticket into eternity tonight because He paid the price. I'll tell you what, I come to you right now, I see you walking down the street, I can say, hey, you want $100? You go, yeah. Man, eternal life is worth way more. You couldn't give me everything in this world in exchange for my salvation. Because I already own everything in the world because God owns it all and I'm His son. I just haven't collected it yet. And we are all joint heirs. So I want to give you that opportunity tonight. I want you to just sit and think about your relationship with the Lord. And those of us who are Christians, I want to share something with you too, because I want to make a double altar call tonight. We have one of those trains in Truckee, too. I wonder if it's the same one. If you'd like to come by right when it's serious, we will wait. Do not leave. I was seeking God with my whole heart. After I've been walking with the Lord for many years, I was a worship leader in our church. But there was just something in my life, I just wanted more. I was singing songs like, I love you, Lord, and I was going, do I mean those words, Lord? I want to know that I mean them. Lord, I want to be on fire for you. Lord, I want to worship you. I want to know you. I want to love you. I started praying that. Years ago, I started praying that. And then, as I was sharing with you a little while ago, is when I woke up paralyzed. And here I was in the hospital. Couldn't move. And for 14 days, I had a battle that went like this. Lord, why don't you heal me? And this still small voice would say, I thought you wanted to know me. Yes, Lord, but heal me. I thought you wanted to worship me. Yes, Lord, but heal me. I thought you wanted to love me. Yes, Lord, but heal me. Every night this went on. I had conditions on my prayer. Well, yeah, Lord, if you heal me, I'll do those things. I want those things, but I want to be healed. 14-day battle of this. And then a brother comes in one evening when they move me down to St. Mary's Hospital in Reno. And he strums the guitar, and we start to sing this song. They sat me up in a wheelchair. They started to sing this song, I love you, Lord. And right when that song started happening, something happened inside me. I said, Lord, I may never, ever walk again. Use me where I'm at. I love you. And my heart was transformed. I was changed into another person right at that time, and I'd never been the same. And I meant it with all my heart. And I looked over at my wife, you know, I could turn my neck, and so then I could move. I looked over at Anna, I said, Anna, I'm okay, I just forgot Jesus. I love him. The first time it came out of my mouth that I really knew that I loved God. And I can look at you guys tonight and say, I love God. Because he transformed my heart. And what did that take? That meant surrender. 100% surrender. That doesn't matter what job I have, doesn't matter who I'm married to, it doesn't matter who my children are, it doesn't matter. God, use me where I'm at. Are you ready for that tonight? Have you been complaining about your spouse? Have you been driving about your work? Did God give you that job so you could take care of your families? When you got married, did God unite the two of you? Is God in control of your life or not? He can change those circumstances, and if he desires not to, well, then that's okay. Can you serve him right where you're at? Can you love God right where you're at tonight? You want to be transformed? Surrender. Give it all. Lord, it's okay. You have me where I'm at. Use me where I'm at. Fill me with your Holy Spirit. I'll tell you, you empty out, he can fill you. If you keep stuff in, he can't fill you. There is no being filled with the Holy Spirit if you got stuff that's not in the way. Got to get rid of it. Be empty so he can fill you. Then he will use you. The only reason I'm here tonight is because God healed me, obviously. I didn't care anymore if I didn't walk. Of course, there would come times, I'm sure, where I would have. But it didn't matter because I knew that one day I'd be with him in eternity and have a brand new body and he could use me where I'm at. And I'm telling you, people in the hospital came to the Lord. Nurses came to the Lord. Patients came to the Lord. There was a joy in the wing of the hospital I was in that was the most incredible thing, that when I finally got out, I was in there 2.5 months. When I finally got out, those nurses and therapists did not want me to leave because the Spirit of God was ministering in the hospital. And I'm telling you something, I was happier than the people that came to visit me. I was happier than the doctors. I was happier than the nurses. They used to come to me and say, Jim, you can vent. You can let it out. I say, I don't got to let it out. I got Jesus. And they couldn't understand it. You want that? I want to pray for you tonight for that. You want to receive Jesus as your Lord and Savior? I want to pray for you tonight. You want to go to heaven? You want to have an abundant life down here? I want to pray for you tonight. So let's pray, okay? Let's pray. Everyone, let's bow our heads and pray. Father, we come before you tonight. Lord God, you are the King of all kings. Lord, you are the God of creation. You are the one who called us to this park tonight. You are the one, Lord, who called us into your kingdom. You are the one who uses us, Lord. It is completely you. And Father, you know every heart in this park. You love each one the same, Father. There is not one better than another. And you desire to use everybody that is here. And Father, I'm praying right now that you touch the hearts of those who have never given their life to you. And that may be you across the street. It may be you down the street that can hear these words. You can invite the Lord in your heart right now, wherever you are. Father, touch their hearts. Minister to their hearts right now, Lord. Show them their need to have forgiveness of sin, Lord. To have their guilt removed. Father, to enter into your kingdom. And it's a free gift, Lord, that you give to them right now if they would receive it. If with your heads bowed, is there someone in here tonight that would like to receive Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior? Have that free ticket into eternity tonight. I'd like for you to raise your hand right now so I can see it. And keep it up, okay? So I can see it. Anybody here got the guts to raise your hand for the Lord? You want that free gift. You do. I see you guys over there. Praise God. Anybody else? Leave your hands up. All right. I see your hand back there, buddy. Anybody else before I stop this prayer? All right. Everybody keep their heads bowed. Pastor John, there's two young guys over here and a young man up by that bowl. Would you go grab them up and pray with them? They raise their hand and you can lean around the Lord. And now the rest of us here, okay, that are believers, I pray and I hope. You heard my testimony. You heard about that transformation in my life. I can sing a song like I love you, Lord, now. And I mean it. Would you like that power in your life? You want that victory in your life? I'd ask that if that's your heart tonight, that if you're sitting down, I'd ask you to stand up right now. And those of you standing, you know your own heart. If you'd like to have that in your life, you'd like that change in your life, you want to know when you sing those songs you mean it, I want you to stand up so I can pray for you, okay? You know if God's tugging on your heart. There you go. Praise God. I know there's more than a few, yeah. I know there's a few more. The desire of your heart. Yeah, amen. Anybody else before I pray? All right, praise God. It takes guts to stand up in a park before the Lord, but He honors that. Father, you see those tonight who are standing before you, Lord. They want that transformation of their heart, Father God. Just, Lord, I want it again too, Lord. I just want to continually be filled with your Holy Spirit, Lord. But Father, these have stood up, Lord, because you're tugging on their heart, Lord. They desire to have the good things that you have to offer them. They desire, Lord, to be used by you in a powerful way. Lord, I pray for them if they're struggling in their circumstances, in their life, they'll be able to lay them at the foot of your cross and just say, Lord, use me where I'm at. Lord, give them that heart, Father. And I know you'll give them opportunity to do that, Father. I pray that they will take it, Lord, and they will walk in faith and believe, Lord, that you're leading them into that contentment. And Lord, I know that you'll use them in such powerful ways, Lord. I see how you use us. I see how you use me, Lord. And I know that you desire to use everyone that way. So, Father, fill them with your Holy Spirit, Lord. Help them to not struggle anymore with their struggles, Lord. Help them to walk with you and know that you are in control of their lives. For your glory and for your honor, in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right, we're going to end with one of our worship songs that's on Anna's worship album. And if you guys would like to, we have tapes and CDs. You're more than welcome to buy them. We don't care. That's a plug, huh? Take us home with you. The newest one that we have is Truckee Graphite 3. It's the yellow one. It may not be the prettiest cover, but it's the best of the Truckee Graphite ones. I'll just tell you that ahead of time. And the Anna one and the Alive 2 are worship albums. The Anna one is songs that my wife has written in those late nights when it's just her and Jesus. And they play it on that station CSN and KNIS, Pilgrim Radio. So be my guest to buy as many as you like. But we're going to sing one of those songs now. Giving Glory to God is Psalm 115:1. It's called Not to Us. So please join us. It's not to us, but to you, O Lord, be the glory and the honor forever.
glory and the honor.
Amen. Thanks for having us, John. Pastor John, did you want to come up and